Hello, all the Bitcoin and blockchain lover. Yeah. Okay, so I believe everyone here coming to this event support the idea to be decentralized, distributed, and transparent, right? So that's our blockchain all about. So these are my presentation by today. This is a crypto in Southeast Asia. So my name is Ara Ezra. Okay, I've been active, involved in few speaking session in Hong Kong, in London before, and last September. So here I am in Miami. Okay, so I'm also a co-founder of Dina Dirham. It is a Southeast Asia fintech company that creating a product in Ethereum blockchain. Okay. So focus on the presentation. Okay, something wrong. Cannot use. Hello? Cannot use? Okay, here you go. So Southeast Asia is a consists of 11 countries. We have a development country, which is like Indonesia and some of the Timor Leste. But we also have a highly developed country like Singapore, currently actively involved in blockchain. Even many companies and many startups currently creating a product which is in the blockchain since in Southeast Asia. And not only that, we also have involvement of bank, financial institution regarding the development of the product of the blockchain technology. Okay, so we have 11 countries in the Southeast Asia. Okay. Well, I had to point this one. Okay. Okay. 1 second, huh? Okay. Okay, so this is Malaysia. We have Singapore, Indonesia, Thailand. Anyone been to Thailand before in Bangkok? Yeah, a few people already go to Thailand. Nice country, yeah? Nice beach, white sand. Yeah? Okay, so we have Vietnam, Brunei. We have King in Brunei that bought many cars in their garage. Philippines, Cambodia, Laos, Myanmar, Timor Leste. So this is a country that involved in Southeast Asia. Okay. So what is the fintech revolution that is currently being developed and currently gaining momentum in Southeast Asia? Okay. So Southeast Asia is a home to 600 million population, which is 100 million over from the current in Europe currently. Okay. So in addition also, smartphone penetration in Southeast Asia currently getting massive feedback from the market itself. It's expecting to be 17% in 2010, but it is 51% in 2015. Okay, so in Indonesia and the Philippines also, we have 12% penetration that expected to hit over 50% increasement of using of smartphone in Southeast Asia. Okay, and money remittance is the major source of Bitcoin growth, because they are using a Bitcoin technology, which is a blockchain technology, to make a realize, to transfer money in second, to make transfer between countries, to easy, and to bring the money into worldwide space using the blockchain technology. Okay. So we have 300 billion Asian group, over 50 billion as well. Okay. In addition, there's also large sector among undeveloped country, which is unbanked popularity, also unbanked area, which is people still waiting. What is the technology to use? Because they don't have any bank account, but then they use fiat money to transfer. But we have a technology that can enable the blockchain to transfer the money faster, easy, and the main point is simplicity. Okay. So most of the opportunities for Bitcoin growth in Southeast Asia, the fact people using to store their money. We have few popular Bitcoin wallet, which is only based on Southeast Asia, which is Singapore, Indonesia, Philippines, Vietnam, and Malaysia. So these are five predictions. What going to be happen in few years in South Asia? Okay, the first one. South Asia has become bigger internet market than America. Why? Because we have consists of 11 countries that total 600 million citizens of South Asia. At least three companies will raise nine-figure rounds. Okay, we have few companies like WeChat, Tencent, which is only focused on South Asia, never come out from South Asia. But then they have a big impact, a big market that can cater all the transaction or the payment using the technology. Okay. So there will be another exit in the excess 500 million. There's a lots of venture capital currently enter South Asia and finding opportunity. And one thing is the year of China. Why it is the year of China? Because currently China is dominating and trying. I believe that one day before, long time before that, Bitcoin popular in Europe, Bitcoin popular in US. But then suddenly, in few years, months or few years, 1 year back, China currently gaining domination of this one. Okay. There will be widespread embrace of fintech. So blockchain technology is including in fintech industry. And currently have many expo, many event and seminar done by private sector, done by government also, and banking and financial institution for fintech event and expo in South Asia. Okay. But we have some witness. We have determined some witness, which is this is a witness that currently facing in South Asia. Okay. We have few program or we have few company that using old style of server that giving token, giving generation of the token. So this is an illegal scheme that currently facing what will happen in South Asia. Okay. So the strategy is they are using emails, they're using phone call, they're using SMS to approach the investor. Okay, second one. There is also a scheme which promised some return, which is didn't realize that it is logic by mind or not, it is logic by head or not, because some of them in fact offer like double in a month, double in 6 months. There's a currently facing in South Asia. Okay. Yeah, their promise of high return, aim at attracting the public to participate in the scheme, and the investor may not be given copy of any documentation. That means there is no KYC, there is no ML procedure of this one, this project that is currently in South Asia. Okay. No assurance that the operator of such scheme can continue to pay the high return. Why? Because they are using just normal server website to lure people to invest because of the return. That's what's happened in South Asia, yeah? Okay, and at one point also, the operator could not invest the deposit. You cannot generate what has already been given to their investor or to their client. Okay? So this scheme will fail eventually. Why? Because it's already only in few months, in 3 months, in 6 months, it already collapsed and closed. Another program also coming in. Okay? Example of program in South Asia. Okay, that I'll just give us some example. This is Geneva in Singapore based, estimation of 10 billion of the total collection. Okay, we have Big Kingdom. Big Kingdom is mainly based in South Asia also, and using Bitcoin to give a generation 10%, 20%, 30% per month. Okay, and another is Swiss Cash. You just can Google Swiss Cash, the most popular program in South Asia in 2006. Okay, Telex Free is from Brazil also, famous, collecting deposit and giving a generation promise of returns. Ufund, which is based also in Malaysia, giving some returns and collapse in 6 months, Ufund. Iraqi dinar, people in Indonesia would like to keep dinar that they think that someday they will get some return or what, but then it's not mean nothing. It's not worthwhile to keep the Iraqi dinar. Okay, France Swiss investment, this is a Philippine base. So what's the solution? So we have seen a weakness in the current system. So what's the solution? And I think blockchain can solve all the solution and give the give the solution to the current weakness that we have in Southeast Asia. Okay. So these are a few startup that I gather the information and a few company that currently using blockchain as their solution for their apps, for their program and for their system. This is a big X. It's a Singapore company. They have an office in Singapore and Jakarta, if I'm not mistaken, Cape Town also. So they offer Bitcoin wallet. So this is currently popular in South Asia. As you can see, Ventura Capital also invests $150 million for this wallet. I'm not sure it's Series A or Series B, but this big wallet in South Asia, biggest one. Okay, so this is another company. It's a Toast based in Singapore also. It's a peer-to-peer money transfer. And they are focused on migrant workers. So someone have working in, let's say, in London. So they want to send money. They're just using the Bitcoin technology or blockchain technology that enable to transfer the money in second. Okay, so we have a third company, CoinPip. This is also a Singaporean company, Singapore-based company that leverage the Bitcoin blockchain to allow global money transfer. But unlike those, CoinPip target remote workers by allowing them to get paid in a faster and easier way. All of this already been enabled and currently running in South Asia. And they are trying to get and cater the market. So to, for the market that want to make a transfer to keep the money using the blockchain technology. So this is an autonomous company. It's a Singapore-based also. You can Google the company. They have come out with a solution that if you want to open up a company, you can have record in the blockchain. And not only that, they also provide a record for shareholder. Let's say you have 20% of the company, it will be locked in the blockchain forever for this technology provided by this company, Singapore Autonomous. Okay. So we have Amilabs company. This is a Thailand-based. It's a registered software company. They have a few products in blockchain also. Alternate asset, commodities. They also provide a token that using a fiat currency. Okay. This is a CoinsPH. They have an Android app. They have an iPhone app, if I'm not mistaken also. They have an iPhone app. And they are popular in Philippines. Why? Because let's say any Philippine want to transfer money to their home. Let's say they are working in London or working in US. They can just using the Bitcoin to transfer the money peer-to-peer among them within the market in Philippines. Okay. So we have Neuroware. This is a development company, blockchain solution, that currently active dealing with bank, offer a solution of blockchain to the bank and financial institution, currently based in Malaysia, Neuroware, the name of the company. Okay, so we have Digix. Digix is the most popular also, I think, because they are using Ethereum as a back-end for their gold-backed token. Okay, and we have Dinar Dirham. This is a Singapore-based company. It's a fintech company. So I'm coming here also to give the solution of Dinar Dirham that provide to the current market in South Asia. Okay. So the first flagship product of the Dinar Dirham is Dinar Coin. What is Dinar Coin? Actually, we have a booth outside. You can see that our digital token can be redeemed into physical gold, one-to-one back. It's one dinar, it's a 4.25 gram. So Dinar Dirham create Dinar Coin, which is on Ethereum blockchain. So all record is in Ethereum blockchain. Okay. But the best part is, why? Because the price fluctuates on every minute, on every second. Because already packed to the gold price. So this is a kind of another token, which is not normal like another token that based on demand and supply. So this is a packed token using Ethereum technology as a behind protocol. Okay, Dinar Coin, DNC token, we call that, DNC token. So we you have 10 DNC, you can redeem 10 coin of gold at one-to-one basis on the price of the current gold, which is already packed. So DNC is a value of 4.25 gram. So the current world gold price is 1 ounce, which is 31.1 gram. So they already been customized for 4.25 gram. Okay, Dinar Coin, it's a DNC token, we call that. So how to minting the Dinar Coin token? So this is a process. I'm going to explain a simple, quick way. Let's say you have fiat. you need to buy Bitcoin, Ethereum or Zcash only using blockchain asset to purchase or minting the DNC. Why? Because we want every transaction will be in blockchain asset. Let's say you have Bitcoin, you can use Bitcoin to minting DNC, and using our wallet, UBW wallet. Let's say you purchase one DNC. Okay, when you purchase one DNC, you will be sending the same value of 4.25 gram to the liquidity provider. Okay, so we call this, it is a LP, liquidity provider. So there is a financial institution that have license to pack the value of the gold. Okay, when you done open the position or order to the LP, then the Ethereum token will become out as a one DNC or two DNC, depends on the value that you send to the LP, to the liquidity provider, that enable that value to be packed on real time. Okay, one-to-one pack on the gold value, okay? So this is a minting process. So this is a burning process. We have minting process and burning process. Let's say you have one dinar coin or two dinar coin. You can use the wallet, close the order, so that when they done close order in the LP or liquidity provider, then you can choose which method you want to withdraw. Bitcoin, Ethereum, Zcash, or we have ATM machine. I also saw the booth offering ATM machine. Already asked them, can they customize the NC token there? Yes, it can be done, he said. So I think ATM machine is also possible. And debit card also currently, we are trying to, actually we're not trying, we already have the same provider as Wirecrest that offering Zappo and Wirex. So we are already done getting the approval from that. Okay. So not only digital token, let's say you have dinar coin, you can redeem to physical gold. One thing that we have physical gold that we involve is 999.9. Only 24 karat of gold what we have in dinar coin. Okay? So no 916, no 735 gold. So pure 999.9, only the product that we have. So your token is in the digital token, which is recorded in Ethereum blockchain. So you own the private key, you can get a keep in the Ethereum blockchain, and not only that, you can redeem to physical gold on one-to-one basis. So it is based on gold value, current value, on every minute, every second. Okay, so this is an overview of dinar coin, the NC Blockchain Explorer. Okay, so where to check the token? You can just go to Etherscan. There's a Blockchain Explorer for the token. You can see how much have been minting, how much have already been burning, how much market capital, and who's the token holder, and every transaction will be recorded in here in real time. Okay, this is a Etherscan. So we have wallet. So this is a, you call this Universal Bitcoin Wallet. Okay, so this is a wallet, www.universalbitcoin.com. Okay, what's so special about this wallet? We have a multi-currency. We have Bitcoin, we have Ethercoin, we have Dinar coin. So let's say you have Dinar coin, you can exchange real-time to Bitcoin, you can exchange real-time to Ethercoin, and not only that, you can store your Bitcoin, your Ethercoin, and your digital back token, digital gold back token, yeah, DNC. Okay. Okay, so we have opportunity because of blockchain, because of Bitcoin. We can see many background. We have lecturer, we have professional lawyer. Even in South Asia, we have a few merchant, we have few startup company that currently involved in blockchain and Bitcoin scene. Okay, so we have a big opportunity in 2017. In fact, in South Asia also, we have seen some banks currently reduce their staff because all everything want to go to digital. So they are promoting a digital transformation in 2017. Okay. So this is an event one time, the event in Kuala Lumpur happened in September 2016. So this is a gathering all the Bitcoin conference and technology. We have a few participation from Indonesia, Singapore, Bangkok, Philippines. Okay, as you can see, we'll have lots of feedback. Many people coming in to the events, supporting the events. Okay, so this is also one event in Sabah, also in Malaysia. Have you someone been to Sabah before? It's also a nice country that have beach. Yeah, I see some people there been to Sabah. So this is a Sabah market that eager want to know what is Bitcoin, what is the special about Bitcoin. Because last time the price only 10 cent. Why come suddenly 1,000 something? So it is attraction and it become something that people would like to know more about Bitcoin and blockchain. Okay. So this event in Singapore, we have a Singapore FinTech Festival in November. You can Google it. The MAS, the Money Authority of the Singapore also support the blockchain and Bitcoin technology. They want to use the blockchain technology to solve all the problem that currently facing our financial system. Okay. Okay. So this event is Indonesia. Okay. We have a few flight. Okay. So what is the conclusion? Okay. So in South Asia, actually there is a lot of potential. We have a few business opportunity. We have a few partnership that can be done, that can be enter into the South Asia. Okay. Bitcoin exchange, exchanger, merchant, licensed liquidity provider, financial institution, investor, technology provider, or forex broker. Okay, I think that's all for now. I have time. Maybe a question? No, yeah? Okay. So thank you everyone for having 20 minutes with me. Okay, it's nice to be in Miami. And I'm nice to present our technology that binadirham.com have. Okay, thank you. Bye.